got the Honda 125 running. Took the back roads to the store. It's about 35 degrees, but it sure feels good not to be walking no more.
What is going on, guys? There are 3,032 miles on the bike right now, right this very moment. And as you can see, the bike's running. Human error, when I put the new cam in, completely my fault. On the cam gear, there's a little spacer that you line up. There's a groove on the cam, that spacer goes in that groove. And I could swear I had it, but it probably popped loose as I was tightening it down, or I didn't have it seated properly. So I'm going to take the blame on that one. T-bolt cam is top notch. I ordered the cam and the cam gear, the new cam gear. I had to replace both because the cam was damaged from the gear falling off. So it's running good. I will tell you that I set the valves to what they had on the forum was, I believe, 0.003, so that's 3,000s. Intake, 3,000s, exhaust. And, dude, I took it for a test drive, and it kept stalling out. So I came back, and I had time today to readjust the valves, and I set them to, and I could be wrong, but I think this is stock. It's 4,000s, 0.004 on the intake and 7,000s on the exhaust, and I had no problems. I've been running around for about 30 miles now, and cam gears, I noticed a difference. Is it going to be enough difference to get it where I need it? So what I needed to do, or why I'm making all the changes, is I needed to be consistent, like at 55. So if I'm on a road that's 55 and I'm going up a hill, you know, I'm cranking it up to 60, I'm going to slow back down. Thanks. Yeah, it's a ground. Pretty fun. So, what I needed to do is I needed to go 60 consistently. And, 55 consistently. So if I go 60 and I'm going up a hill and I'm hitting 60 and I'm going to drop back some, as long as I can go on those roads that are 55 and not get run over from behind because the ground's slowing down, I'm not gonna hit my brakes and my brake lights aren't gonna be on. And if I'm going up a hill and I start at the hill at 58 and I slow down to 50, 55 and keep going slower, people behind me don't know I'm slowing down because my brake lights aren't on. Then there's no hazard. So I needed to be consistent for at least highways of 55 miles per hour. So that's the goal with all the changes I made. And the only changes I've really made, it had the intake on it when I got it. I put an exhaust, and again, it's the AR exhaust off of Amazon. Not a very expensive exhaust. I got the Power Commander 5. I know there's a bunch out there. I went with the Power Commander because at the time I bought it, you know, as I did my research, that was the best one. Now in my research, there's a whole bunch of cool stuff. Changed the cam to a T-bolt cam. Those changes are made. I would like to have it Dyna-tuned, just to have them fine-tune everything and get it running top-notch and see where that gets me. So right now, that's my next step, is getting to the Dyna-tune, and then I should be good. There's the new bus garage here in Barberton. They got a loan to do the bus garage. They tore down the old bus garage, so this is where they're at on it. Coming along. Will it be done by school start in August? Yeah, I don't know. I think they got all the buses parked in the fence back there. Something's going on at the high school today. Or I don't know what it is. But I'm going back up. I'm going to continue on my travels. Thanks for watching, my friends. And, got it up and running. Had some nice days to ride when it was down. I'm not going to lie. It was a bummer. But, hey, Michigan Moto Man, if you want to take that cross-country trip, I'm in. I'm good. It's running. So I'm good. I can maybe even catch up with you here at some point. Thanks for watching, my friends. If you like, hit the subscribe button, tell a family member, tell a friend, tell a paper boy. Hit that little ring-a-ding bell. We ain't ever getting old. I'm gonna hit that button there. That guy behind me has no idea what the hell I'm doing. I don't even know what the hell I'm doing.